beautiful ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for being with us here again tonight. Join us for Christian and Ruth's wedding. Weather this evening, pretty beautiful. Should be a solid 4 hours coming up of dancing and partying.
Someone I'm lucky to call not only my brother, but more importantly, my friend. He's already the happiest, most carefree person I've ever known, but since meeting Ruth, I've never seen him happier.
It was close to about 6 years now, guys, that they actually met. Time has flown by.
Oh, you look so cute!
I was coming to Boston for work for about 2 months.
I was working at Enterprise Rent
a
Car.
My company likes to save a dollar, so instead of renting a car from the airport,
they took a taxi over to a random tiny location, and I happened to be working one person at that location.
Imagine that, everyone. The very first hour she landed in Boston, she met Christian.
I was supposed to rent her a car. I ended up not being able to because she didn't have a license, which gave me the opportunity to give her my number and say, yeah, I can get you all squared away once you have your license and everything figured out. Rented it to her boss.
He upgraded my car. He went through all the radio stations. He's a smooth guy. I got my license information, so I gave him a call.
She said, is there anything I can do to make it up to you? You took good care of us. It's like, the least you could do is just take me out to dinner.
I said I would go for a drink.
We kind of bounced around and had a fantastic night.
We really hung out almost every single day. And after that 2 months, it was time for me to go back to Toronto.
For everyone here that has not met my father, he was the type of man whose strength and loyalty, love and passion, has so much purpose in everything he did. These are qualities that I actually see in both you, Ruth, and Christian.
My dad had been ill for a very long time, and that was actually about probably a week after arriving home.
Her father ended up passing. I just remember thinking, I know what she's going through, and I've been there. I called my boss, I said, hey, is it cool if I take tomorrow off? I left at probably midnight, and I got up to the Canadian border. It's probably like 7 a.m. or so.
I got the call when he was at the border. I didn't even know he was coming.
Christian, that was such a special gesture to all of us.
Ruth, to honor and respect you, a promise I made to your father on the one call we ever had. To put you first as always your husband, and to be our unborn children's best dad.
Christian, you are everything my dad prayed for me to find. You are my rock, you are my foundation, you are my family.
Christian, numerous times you drove to Toronto at a drop of a hat just to see Ruth and build this love. Ruth, you maybe made the biggest sacrifice and commitment at all and moved your entire life to Boston away from your friends and family in Toronto. The two of you knew it was not going to be easy from the start. You both worked hard at making it successful and continue to work hard at making the bond between the two of you more than just a word. But a love that you can trust, that is so true inside of your hearts because of your efforts, commitments, and sacrifices.
I will love you through the peaks and valleys, no matter how dark. I'll be your best friend and never lose that romantic spark.
I've got myself a catch that I'm going to hold on to for eternity.
I promise to love, honor, and respect you, Ruth, Evelyn, Ann, and wear the greatest honor to be your forevermore.
When my dad left this world, my heart was left with a hole. Christian Henry Wright, you fill my soul. We share the same soul.
I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Wright.
Christian, I know you'll make a spectacular husband and Ruth a spectacular wife. I know your mom and Ruth's dad, along with all your grandparents, are looking down on us today with a big smile. They're so happy for you both.
I just want to leave you with a few things that your dad would have said that are attributes from the Bible to keep with you. Long-suffering, joy, self-control, peace, meekness, temperance, goodness, faith, patient endurance, moral excellence, and of all, love. I'm not asking you to run away. Could you try to take a single step? How can you lean forward when you're halfway out the door? So you made mistakes you have regrets. I don't need you to be perfect. Just promise you'll be honest. I promise that it's worth the risk. But I can't make you love me, even if I try. I'm not gonna force you, you have to decide. I'm asking you to trust me when I say that I'm not here for the moment. I'm in this for life. Yes, I know you've been hurt before. And life will lay you low, oh, that I'm sure. But just say the word, baby, and I'm yours. I'll be a shelter, keep you safe and warm.
The family that we have in the tent tonight, it's truthfully everybody that means so much to us, and couldn't ask for a better cast of folks in our lives, and you've truly shaped who we are today. Without further ado, I think we got a party ahead of us. Dance for you, relax. Yeah.
So we're moving on, no turning back. I promise that I'm honest. There are greater things ahead, but I can't make you learn me, even if I try.
You are definitely her soulmate. You complement each other, and together you're going to have a strong, loving family unit.
Yes, I know you've been hurt before. And life will lay you low, that I'm yours. But just say the word, baby, and I'm yours.
Many years of good vibes, making memories, and your next chapter as husband and wife. Love you too.